Tonight, the music world mourning the loss of legendary rapper MF Doom. The public rarely saw his face, but they knew his voice. Daniel DeMille passed away at the age of 49. He was best known by his stage name MF Doom, a famously mysterious masked rapper and producer who gained a cult following across the world. His wife confirmed his death yesterday, saying he passed away back on October 31st.
By now, you've probably seen this masked cartoon vigilante on your social media feed. You're probably wondering, who is this masked dude? Why are all my favorite rappers paying so much respect to him? That's a good question. Today we're gonna look at the backstory and the impact MF Doom has had. Imagination, justice mentioned. If I was a bird, I'd be a pigeon. Sick of wonder crumbs and pizza crust. When every fella can eat fresh fish and live fat like a pelican. Then again, that's only if you're capable for freckles. So you're probably asking, why the mask? Well, MF Doom got his persona from a lot of different places, but the main inspiration came from the Dr. Doom character from the Fantastic Four.
Right, look, I'ma come with the angle of, it don't matter what I look like, you know, it don't matter what the artists look like, it's more what the artists sound like. So the mask really represents the whole, like, to rebel against the trying to sell the product as a human being, you know what I mean?
Victor Von Doom is a fictional supervillain appearing in American comic books published by Marvel Comics, created by Stan Lee. The character made his debut in the Fantastic Four comic book series in July of 1962. Dr. Doom, Victor Von Doom, these names come up numerous times in MF Doom's albums. Victor Von Doom is a genius from the fictional country of Latvia. He used magic and science to protect the people of his place from the enemy of his country. He later went on to get a scholarship in New York City, where he met Reed Richards, you know, the stretchy guy from Fantastic Four. You know, the guy that stretches and stuff like that. Shocker, they become academic rivals. Whoa. He creates a machine to talk to the dead to try to save his mother. His mother made a deal with the devil and she lost her soul. He was trying to save her. Reed Richards looked into his machine and he said that something was wrong with it, but he ignored his warnings. As he continues to figure out his machine, an explosion happens. There's always an explosion. There's always a laboratory experiment gone wrong. Why that is? He's later expelled from university and wanders the earth. He later gets rescued by Tibetan monks. They teach him magic and he creates a magic science armor, and thus Dr. Doom is created. So why Dr. Doom? Why this particular character? Why not Iron Man or Wolverine or Cyclops from X-Men? Well, just like Dr. Doom, MF Doom has his own vengeance story. Dumoulin was born in London on the 9th of January 1971. He's the son of a Trinidadian mother and a Zimbabwean father. He moved with his family to Long Island, New York. Dumoulin formed a rap group called KMD in 1988 with his younger brother DJ Sub Rock and another MC called MC Rodan. The group was later signed to Electrical Records. It seemed like everything was going right until a tragedy struck. His brother was struck by a car and killed while attempting to cross an expressway. The group was dropped from Electrical Records due to their controversial album cover. After his brother's death, Dumoulin retreated from the hip-hop scene from 1994 to 1997. He was homeless, he was walking the streets of Manhattan, and he was sleeping on benches. He made it back to the rap scene a few years later, 1997 to 1998 to be specific, and took up the supervillain persona as a way to seek vengeance on the industry that wronged him. MF Doom is known for his wordplay, and he frequently incorporates samples and quotations from film. His flow was loose and conversational, but delivered with technical precision, and his use of rhyme and meter eclipsed that of Big Pun and Eminem. He has a cult-like following. His vibe is very nerdy and intellectual. He talks a lot about comic book stuff and cartoons. He even has a whole album where he just references cartoons from Adult Swim.
You're watching Christmas with Doom on Adult Swim, and now, Aqua Teen Hunger Force. Roll it.
MF Doom has released 6 studio albums, 2 live albums, and 10 instrumental albums, and much more. The most celebrated album of MF Doom's discography is Mad Villainy, Food, and Operation Doomsday. My favorite songs from MF Doom are Rhymes Like Dimes, Doomsday, and All Caps. All Caps is the first song that I heard from MF Doom. All Caps when you spell the man's name. His samples and instrumentals are some of the best I've heard. It's almost like you're in a movie when you listen to his music. It's almost like a movie soundtrack.
How did they get there?
Regular storage procedure. The same as the other food. The other food stopped coming, and they started.
How did they get there?
Regular storage procedure. The same as the other food.
The way he takes you back to certain places, or like an old time, or like he puts you into a comic book world or something like that. MF Doom has impacted a lot of artists that you wouldn't even think about. For example, Danny Brown, Kenny Beats, Playboi Carti, Tyler the Creator, Childish Gambino, and even your Canadian friend Drake, and much, much more. I could go on forever. I personally started listening to MF Doom in 2017 when I wanted to be a rapper. I wanted to study from the greats, and I heard that MF Doom was one of the best lyricists in his time. I found myself relating to MF Doom in terms of the fascination he had with comic books and cartoons, as well as him just coming with the bars, the boom bap bars that I like so much. What do you think about Dr. Doom? I'm sorry, MF Doom. Are you gonna start listening to his music now that he's gone? I think you should check out Rhymes Like Dimes and Doomsday, and let me know if you like it. All right, don't forget to like, comment, and subscribe. I'll be coming again next week with some fire, and hit the notification button. Don't forget to like, comment, subscribe, blah, blah, blah. Victor Von Doom is a fictional supervillain appearing in a comic. I can't fucking read.